In this tutorial, I'm going to show you step-by-step how to update FL Studio without losing any of your settings or files. If this is your first time here and you want to learn all about FL Studio and music production in general, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell as well. So, let's get to it. Everything will remain the same after updating as it was before the update. Here I have some VSTs and effects that I've added as favorites. I also have some extra folders for my samples and so on, as you can see here. Now, I want to upgrade to the latest FL Studio version without having everything reverting to the default settings. If you're using a more recent version of FL Studio like I do, you'll get a message like this telling you that a new version is available. In that case, just click Download and it will take you to the download page. If you have an older version, you'll have to navigate to the download page manually, like this. It will always display the most recent version. I'm using Windows, so I'll click here. Once the download is complete, make sure that you don't have FL Studio running. In that case, if you do, close it first and then open the update file. I recommend right-clicking on it and select Run as Administrator just to be sure. Click Next. Yes, I agree. If you have more than one user on your computer, you might want to limit this just to you. Otherwise, just click Next here. We don't want new settings, so turn this off. Note that if you're upgrading to a less recent version, like say from FL Studio 11 to FL Studio 12 or something, then you'll want to check the Migrate settings. Click Next and then navigate to the folder where your current FL Studio installation is. It will usually show up by default. If you're not sure where it is, then just right-click on the icon and select Properties to view the location. In my case, this looks fine, so let's click Next. Here you can select your VST folders. Next. It will now overwrite the old program files. By the way, if you would like detailed feedback on your music, mastering, and so on, then you might want to check out my services. I'll put the link in the description below. Okay, moving on. Next. Now let's open FL Studio. Go to Help and then About. As you can see, we now have the latest version installed. You might have to manually register FL Studio again, though. No big deal. In this case, just type in your username and password here or import your license file. If I go to File, you'll see that all my folders are present, just as before. My data folder is also unchanged, which means that everything should be as it was before. All your personal settings are stored in the data folder itself, and you can actually have different layouts or settings in different data folders, and then switch between them. For example, I have one data folder for my own personal stuff, and another one for my tutorials. Check out my video about data folders if you want to learn more about that. I'll put the link in the description below. What do you want our next video to be about? Let us know in the comments below, and make sure to like, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.